Okay. So, first of all, my hair is a mess, but that's whatever. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Is, first of all, I have some things to, one, say for YouTube and anybody that may be joining in. I did do some stuff offline, so I'll go ahead and reveal that while I can. Taint and Kaza both got evolved, right? I traded them with Diamond, and I evolved them, basically. And I also, to save us time from doing slots and slots and slots, I also traded over a psychic. I traded over a couple TMs. Some of them I'm going to hold off on using just for the sanctity of it being fairly legal. The two that I remember, I think I remember three of them actually. It was Psychic, which is available now in the slots. There was Sword Stance, which I believe is also available in the slots. I'll double check that. If it is available, I'm probably going to hold off on it. Yep, Veilstone Game Corner, 4,000 coins. So yeah, that's perfectly street legal as well. And then I also did, I brought over Charge Beam, which I know you get from Volkner, so that's gonna be iffy. But I think a Rock Slide as well. So those are the four TMs I traded over, as well as getting them evolved. And pretty much that's majority of what I did offline. I think I also have, I don't know if I left it underground. We'll go ahead and pop it underground just to look at my bag. Because I think I left the treasures that I found in my treasure bag. Alright, no. But I did talk to myself 9 times. So, I want to be doing that more and more later on. I just wanted to show that up before, just to start off the episode for today. Okay. So, we do have Houndour in the mix. I wouldn't be opposed to just snatching up the Houndour. However, there are some Graveler and Geodude in the grass there. I feel like as soon as I encounter one of those, I'm just going to run. Rhyhorn, I think we can take, because I don't think Rhyhorn learns self-destruct. But all in all, it should be pretty fun today. I actually plan on doing a lot of things, including challenging Malian's gym at some point. So first things first, I guess. We will teach. Oh, okay. So I did get grab psychic already. I shouldn't have done this off screen, but I'll show it anyway. I taught psychic instead of mean luck. And I also taught it the focus blast. So this is Gengar right now. It's pretty scary for, you know, all that. I should probably teach a Shadow Claw at some point here soon. Let's look at all the trainers on this route. Because the last thing I want to do is get accosted. Okay, there's a collector. Collector with three of the evolutions. There's also one with a bunch of how do you say it? They're Great Marsh Pokemon. There's also a Ruin Maniac. I think we fought him already. Maybe not. I don't know, like, a good chunk of these should be manageable. I'll just have to make sure I know who is who before fighting them. Okay, this is... He's not a psychic. Is he the private investigator with the Goldeen? I don't have... Okay. It's actually going to be a little bit of a problem. I'll go withdraw Touch Me Not right now. Have I tried not suiciding Pokemon? Sadly enough, that's pretty much how all of them have died. Not actual, like, suicide, but... I do need... Carpe Diem needs to level up. Is this just a Nuzlocke? Yeah, it's just Nuzlocke. No, there's no, so there, if you do the Command Cool Fist, there is a Pace Spin with it all. Thing is, I don't need Carp right now. They answer nothing. Oh god. Okay. So what do you mean then? What's your question? Oh no, there's no randomizer. This is vanilla. Vanilla. This is actually my first Nuzlocke, so, like, I wanted to do something normal. Honestly? Yeah. I'll take out Ariel Black for now. I'm not happy about it. Dude, that's terrible. Right, so this guy should have just a Goldeen. Actually, is Horndrill... Is Horndrill just normal? Oh, then this... Yeah, it doesn't have Drill Peck, though. If this is the guy, I think it is. Then I should have no problem with... Yeah, it is. Okay, cool. Because it has Horndrill and Flail. Unless Flail is dark. But I'm pretty sure it's normal. Yeah, it's normal. But all your time when the Emerald and Fire Red. Fair. I wouldn't say they were terrible. I do enjoy most of the games past Platinum. I also wouldn't say that White and Black, like I recently just played through White and Black. I wouldn't say they held my hand. If anything, they were probably the last challenging gen before, EXP share all isn't in black. True. I still liked it though. I have no idea which collector this is. If it's three. Oh no, it's six. Okay. So I'll swap into a... Ooh, it has knockoff. So yeah, I'll definitely swap into Sponge here. Rocket was cliche mafia gang. True. Should be some nice experience going to I'm gonna have to be fast here. Actually, it doesn't know any flying moves. So we're good. See, plasma was weird where, like, spoilers for anyone that hasn't played Black and White, I guess. But they were definitely weird. They were like, we should release all Pokemon, but we're gonna use these Pokemon to do our deeds. And then in the end you find out that what's his face? God. Getsus was playing in all along. So, I mean, makes sense. I will say the lead up to the end there, it was pretty weird in terms of just like everything playing out. Because you don't end that game as a champion. Okay, this is the one Pokemon that I should bring in a. Honestly, the best Pokemon for Krogunk would probably be, I haven't played in X and Y in a second, so I wouldn't be able to say entirely what it was. But I do understand that dude, New Vegas is pretty good. I really did enjoy New Vegas, especially with all the DLC and everything. I didn't like one of them, but the rest of them were really good. I mean, yeah. At the same point, like, people looked at it and were like, they were either hit or miss with New Vegas. Okay, what does Beauty have? Wormadam. That's easy enough. They all have hidden power and confusion, actually. I should be more careful with the fights I pick. I told you it's vanilla Cool Fizz. Flat vanilla. Let's hope that doesn't hurt. It is a vanilla Nuzlocke, but it's not randomized. It's straight vanilla platinum with slightly tweaked rules. Like instead of it being a first, like a first encounter isn't the one I have to catch. I can pick which ones I'm catching, basically. But if I encounter a Pokemon that I'm wanting to catch, I have to lock in that is my encounter. Alright, so this psychic has Duskull, and a Kadabra. I don't think this is Taint's fine to. Honestly, I'm not really set up against Kadabra. I might lose a Pokemon here if I try to attack. Also, apparently, I don't have super potions or normal potions. That's terrible. Yikes. Oh, how the times have changed. Yikes, okay. Well, I'm here, I might as well heal. There's no reason not to. I do have Sucker Punch on Gengar. True. But this Duskull also has Shadow Sneak, which at level 26 it might be able to KO with something that it's also one level ahead. I want to see something. Honestly, I'm going to regret heavily, heavily regret. We are so gonna die. Luckily, none of these Pokemon really have two people at your work tested positive. Jesus. See, the whole thing is weird now. Okay. You gotta watch out for the Heracross because it has a aerial ace. Colby. Okay, this guy just has three Machokes. And they can't hit me with anything really, unless he uses Foresight immediately. It should be decent XP. Especially for Carpe Diem. Gonna be risky. I shouldn't, but Kaza needs levels. And it outspeeds. Ooh, that might be the saving day. Oh, just Foresight? Get that out of here. Mm-hmm. Is there any reason to be in this little hole? No. I actually had one of the AI switch out earlier against Nose Pass. Wait, what was the purpose of that? Oh. Yeah, that would do it. I do have to watch out because the Meditite coming up can learn or can use confusion. Yeah. To be fair, though, I'm also, like, trying to take it as safe as I can. Because I've made dumb mistakes, even with looking up. Keep Kaza in. A low rider. It's kind of funny. Ooh. Foresight. Oh no. I will use my only attacking move. Never mind. I will get rid of Miracle-Eye. Enables the user to hit a dark type with any type of move. It also enables the user to hit an evasive foe. Why am I just now learning about this? It wouldn't be useful. That's very situational. Doesn't that block me off? Did the two trainers actually block me off from where I'm supposed to go? Oh shit, this is the Crobunk. I like how my Gengar is a low speed Gengar and it's still up there. Thank you. Didn't Nature Hunt Navy Hunt? Okay, so here's the thing, right? I'm playing it off of the fact that like the first Pokemon of the type that I want, I have to catch or make that my encounter. There we go. This is not a confusing gym at all. So this must be Heracross guy. With Aerial Ace and everything. Had his chance. Thing is, right? I'm nowhere near the level to be able to survive. What's the point of breaking that if you can't? Huh. No, there wouldn't be a hidden item in a gym. That would just be silly. Yeah, but you couldn't go around it. I don't think I am, I don't think I'm ready. Metal Claw is so scary. As well as Rock Tomb. Thank you. You only know Mega Drain. And Cut, I guess. Do I lead with Stun Spore? I'm severely underleveled for the melee. I'll lose somebody here, and it's not gonna be pretty. I'm gonna keep Carp out just due to the fact that I don't want him alive if anything does go south. Bone Rush is scary. I don't know where my Quick Claw is. I think it's on Probo. Okay, it's not on Probo. Is it on a dead Pokemon? No. It should just be in my bag then. Oh, God. Thing is, turn one fake out is bad. The fact that I have to solve the puzzle again is kind of sad. That's dumb. Because you can't push it from the bottom. Not ready. Thanks, Marathon. We're going to take on Maylene pretty underleveled. I'm not ready. I don't think I have anything for Ariel Black. Okay. I'm scared. Actually, it's going to be turn one fake out. Just be prepared for it. Nothing much. Oh, God. Yeah, I don't want to lead with Kaza if he's just going to get... This is probably the safest? It's not. Regret. It didn't lead with fake out. Okay. Not what I was expecting. So I'll throw out Kaza. Confusion. Okay, so now it's paralyzed and confused. Whew, it was going for a big hit. Oh yeah, definitely. Definitely go ahead and learn that. Put it over Mega. Side beam would be a better move, and it is boosted by the plate. I'm going to keep Kaza in. That is a rough metal claw. But that is a great sign. I'm going to heal. Yeah, let's just drink some Moo Moo. It'd be the safer option. Come on, hit yourself. Did I just win? Assuming this doesn't crit. Okay, the plate did its job. The psychic plate did its job. That's number four. We didn't lose anyone to this gym. Didn't lose anybody to the gym. And we were under-leveled. Well, be honest, I got really scared when Kaza's health went down. Honestly. So, here's the thing, right? If I had used Disable on, like, first turn, if I had used Disable on first turn, I would have gotten rid of Mega Claw or Metal Claw. Then I could have just swapped out Gengar and then swept. I didn't think about the move set. Oh. Okay. I'm surprised I lived that one. Meditite not leading out with Fake Out threw me for a loop. Because that's something I thought that would have definitely happened. Alright, well, we're going to gain access to fly here soon, so that's going to be nice. Kaza lives to speak another day, and he tanked through an entire gym. And honestly, he might be a keeper. Just not for Not for Byron. 100% not for Byron. Okay. So, for Team Galactic, though, Kaz is gonna be up there. The other thing that I have to worry about for that is Skuntank, to be honest. Alright. So let's go ahead and put Carp back in. Gengar, you're not done, you're just taking a small break. Kaza, you're gonna stay in. Touchmanot, go ahead and take a small break. Did I heal at all? I did. Who's in the lead? That should be fine, but I'm gonna... Okay, so it's actually a bit boss. Torp was the last one to donate to the stream. So he is on the stream until somebody else pops him off of there. I mean, if you want, go right ahead. I think it was a sub last time. So really anything can probably take it out. It's locked at 100. Just so that everybody has a fair chance of getting on there at some point. Okay, that's against Clefairy. Just fine. That's not great. Really not the best move Clefairy could have used being on my team. Yo, that's always fun. I do understand that a little too much. Oh, please don't explode. True. He does have some good stuff going for him, though. I'm really scared about this Clefairy using Metronome next to me. I've always loved Looker. Especially since this was his introduction. Oh God. Okay. Somebody going live. I really wish I didn't need defog. So actually, going forward, I'm gonna have to prepare for water and water ground. Not the best for Monferno. I could... I could probably get away with a Leafeon. I also know that Touch Me Not's not gonna sweep. So the fights leading up to it, we're probably going to need Sponge. But as for actual need, I need a water type, honestly. I will need a water type going forward. I mean, I have Carp. Obviously, but I'll keep Sponge in the party. Actually, it'd probably make more sense to have Rainbow in the party that get levels. Fissure, you can take a break. This is a small one though, not a big one. I will need more coverage here soon. The biggest threat, I think, right now is the Quagsire. I think this is going to be my hole-in-one, my type coverage. Now that I have fly, I really don't have need for teleport. And charge beam is going to boost his attack. Do I think it's the best idea going forward? Probably not. Is it an idea though? Yeah. Alright, we are done with Veilstone at the moment. Do I even want to take that Duskull on? Duskull and Kadabra. Honestly, Kadabra's match would just be flat out Probo. Always hated that spinner. Okay. Any and all Geodude family, we're just running away from. Cause can't swim. Met his end by one of them. Honestly, this should be fine. Pokemon, touch me not. Looking for a Houndour. If we get a Houndour to pop up, we'll try to catch it. This is the guy with the three evolutions. Starts off with a jolt. Now I do need levels though. I hope I don't lose Linebud to Jolteon. Because Linebud is actually pretty strong physically. That's not great. That's really not great. Okay. Just do this. See, that kind of switching is what gets everyone in a pickle. There's the oh, not the Ember. Wow. Surprising, really. Come on. Come on, dude. This is not great. There we go. Still not enough to kill, though. Cool. That is, though. Switch. Into touch. I do need to get better, Dude, these sand attacks are getting annoying. Not great. But doable. Alright. I'm gonna heal the psychic. Or not heal the psychic. Fight the psychic. Thank you. This is gonna be dangerous. I might not make it out alive. Leads with Dusk. Which is not who I'm worried about. Nice crit. I think this is probably the best play. Guess it's a chance for the special attack to go up. It doesn't always go up. Alright, but that was that. Cue the experience. Into evolution, right? Learned Bite. It's great. Wow, I really shouldn't have ran through the grass with Touchmanot in the lead. Actually, you know what? It's fine. So that big root that we just got, 100% going on Touchmanot. If we get Houndour, we'll just switch out. But if we get Rhyhorn, we'll just grind. Actually, we only have one more Giga Drain, so probably not. What's the Maniac have? Either a shield on or a Bronzor and a Kranidos. Run away. Run away. Okay, this is just a shard. Don't think I fought this guy either. I'm like full on daring the game to strike me down at this point. Okay, this is the bronze ore. It should be just neutral, right? Yeah. With a crit. Also, synchronized would have taken care of that. Go ahead and swap out. I have one, so I gotta make it count. Great. Need one turn where he doesn't. That's just in that range. Where I don't want to risk. Yep. This is where Leech Seed would come in handy, by the way. I really just wanted to, like, use Scary Face again. But it's probably not going to. I need to pay attention to how much damage takedown's doing. All Alright, that was 44. And that was at the bottom of the range. I cannot lose Touchman on here. And I don't want to swap into anybody else. Because I don't think anybody else could really tank it. Also, yeah, that put me just in the range of death right there. If I try to swap out, I'm going to get hit with pursuit. Now that was top range right there. I'm drinking milk. That didn't do 22 damage. I'd be in there. It's too risky. Granted, I'm wasting a bunch of my healing. One crit and I'm like done. Dunzo. Honestly, like, swapping in the carp might not be a bad idea. But again, that's something I don't want to risk. Let it kill itself. That was way too scary for that. I'm gonna heal and then I'll make my way down to I don't know why I didn't just fly. I do have that option now. Jeez, every time it goes off. Okay, I know Lake Valor Lakefront counts as a different area. So different Pokemon to encounter here. Beaverall, Girafarig, Houndour, Staravia. Nothing explosion worthy. And Cricketune, I guess. This might be decent area to take a breath. Here's the thing, right? Okay, what is the 28 versus 23 and 24? Honestly, I might just kill for the Yikes. Girafarig is not something to mess around with. I've lowered its attack twice, so that's fine. I think I want Houndour on this route, actually. That's pretty scary, though, for Girafarig. Can't lie. Not the best team to switch into. I also don't have that much in terms of healing anymore because of that Kranidos. I'm gonna hope that that's not cool. Honestly, though, This is pretty scary. Pretty sick. Pretty scary stuff. Also, so is that, but it's not nearly as powerful as it could be. What is that? Trick room? That's not great. An unforeseeable accident will occur. I just swear there's something in the trash can. Isn't there double battles in here? No, but there are battles in there. All right, 213, a route of mystery. And a route where I will more than likely lose. Okay, there are floatzel on this route. Oh, if I was playing diamond or pearl. There are buizel though. I They're also Shellos. Going forward, what do I really need? I'm what you could call severely underleveled right now. And it scares me. Do you have both kinds of Shellos? I'm actually surprised I got the right number of steps there. Huh. don't have B barrel with me. Wing goal. It's actually not the worst pick. Though I think Gastrodon will help me out later more than Wingull will. Alright, made it to Pastoria. And we're royally screwed for Wake. Royally. I don't think there's any way to muscle our way out of this one. So I will not approach the gym just because I know I'm going to get my butt kicked if I approach the gym and stay away from the gym. Ugh. Alright, cool. First off, Carp, what can you learn? Just Thrash. Touch Me Not should have a ton. Ooh, cut's gonna undermine me. I'll definitely do Leech Seed though, because it's a better stalling move. Get rid of stun. All right. I don't think I quite need 22. Think 15 should do. Alright. I actually do have to be up in the morning. And honestly, 2 hours in. I think this is probably gonna be a good place to stop it. Just due to the fact that we're gonna be on our way to catching that Ralts. But I'm gonna save that for next time. Leave this as a no-death episode. because that's how we do it. And then next episode, we're going to pretty much wipe the Barry and Wake. I am definitely not ready for Wake and Torp. So, yeah. Get up there. And I want to thank you guys for watching. I'll see if there's anybody I can raid.